instead of the Berber.
There is the above-ground Jerusalem with its ancient holy sites, and there is the below-ground Jerusalem. That below-ground Jerusalem just got more interesting with the discovery of a large underground hall that helps bring alive the history from 2,000 years ago.
We are currently actually in the middle of the Second Temple period. It's like imagine to yourself time machine. It's the whole immersive experience. And one of the only places in Israel when you're not like just, okay, this stone is from the Second Temple time, or this wall is not. No, this whole area, we are surrounded by the Second Temple period.
The immense rooms were used as a triclinium, or a rest area, for Israelite dignitaries on their way to the temple. The rooms will be a new feature on the route of the Western Wall Tunnels, an archaeological site adjacent to the Western Wall. The wall is the only remaining part of the Second Temple complex destroyed in 70 AD by the Romans.
These latest excavations have revealed the building that was built here, next to the wall to the south, and it was one of the fanciest buildings from that time. We are very close to the Temple Mount, which is one of the most important and holiest places we have, and it makes sense that we are finding such impressive buildings here.
The most recent excavations were a partnership between Shachar Puni's antiquity authorities and Shlomo Tal's Western Wall Heritage Foundation.
Their job was to understand what is happening here, and our job is the storytelling, to tell the story, to bring a person into being inside the time of the Second Temple with all the challenges of it, or with all the glory, with all the challenges before the destruction and the destruction.
Before the COVID pandemic shut down tourism to the Western Wall Tunnels, more than 150,000 people visited every year. Few foreign tourists have been able to return, but Israelis are coming to explore these impressive new discoveries. Linda Gradstein for VOA News, Jerusalem.